The youth alone can. Yours is going to be the future. So when you are in the present, you have got two responsibilities on your shoulders. Number one, you have to wipe clean some of the weaknesses that have come in the past. Number two, you have to remold the present to a covetable future. Both these responsibilities are on the shoulders of the youth. A nation where the youth have stopped thinking, it cannot survive in democracy. No, we must bring about a change. Take your responsibilities on your own shoulders. You have broad shoulders. This wonderful problem of India. Oh, 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 the Hindus and Muslims are fighting. For what? Rama Janma Bhumi. Is it really speaking a quarrel between Hindus and Muslims? Have you looked at the problem properly? Rama Janma Bhumi, Krishna Janma Bhumi, Kashi, the most historical thing. Mohenjo-daro days onwards, is Kashi important? All right. All those places, they built a mosque that the temple is in the lap of the mosque. This is not mosque for prayer. They were all victory monuments. Now the younger generation of Muslims want to wipe it clean. And when they try to do so, the fundamentalists, the old school, will not allow them. Is it not a national program? Unless you want to vitiate it into a mere communal problem. It is a national problem. We are trying to revive the nation. Once that mosque is removed and Rama temple is being built, it is not for Rama Hinduism that we are doing it. Without the Rama temple, Rama Janma Bhumi, is not Rama is already in the heart of everybody? Isn't Rama anywhere gone down? By building the temple, do you think that our devotion for Rama will increase? It has nothing to do with our devotion to Narayan. But what we are doing is only to bring out that consciousness, both in the Hindus and in the Muslims, that we have wiped clean one dirty corner of our history. And to that extent, we are a nobler nation. Is it not then thereafter that the youngsters or the Muslims and the Hindus will be coming into the mainstream line of national resurgence? Will they not both feel proud of their own nation? Will not the Hindus feel proud that I am a Hindu? Similarly, Islam will have the same pride that we have cleansed our past. Is it not? We have done our atonement for having ill-treated the Hindus and remolded the present with a new strength that you discover in yourself, in your self-consciousness, that you are a nation. We will be able to build up the future and create a future, live happily ever after.